Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, my dear brothers, sisters, elders, respected scholars, and all those who are watching from around the globe. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. The past three episodes, we have been looking at the sermons of Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam, which were delivered after the Battle of Karbala. Although Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam was born many centuries ago, her strength, her bravery, her courage, and response to her life experiences continues to provide a timeless and universal example to women worldwide. In a world where people are desperately trying to find role models to emulate and be inspired by, we look no further than the granddaughter of the Holy Prophet of Islam, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam. Okay, so in the previous episodes, we discussed the sermons of Sayyidah Zainab. We discussed female leadership, we discussed female educators, we discussed hijab, and today I want to speak about patience. She began her life by teaching herself patience, seeing her grandfather, the Holy Prophet of Islam, someone who sacrificed so much for humanity, remain unburied for 3 days. Then the horrific murder of her mother and father. Throughout the Battle of Karbala, after the Battle of Karbala, through her interactions and through her speeches, she always maintained a level of patience. She had to control her emotions at the most heartbreaking moments, a moment which the angels and skies wept for. She had to conform herself and remain strong for what was to come ahead. Instead, she looked to the sky and she said, "Oh God, accept this sacrifice from us." Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam was the embodiment of patience, just like her mother. And in today's episode, I want to look at the qualities of both these two great women and the qualities that both these great women had, because I think it's beautiful to mention how Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam was so much like her mother. It puts emphasis on the importance of the mother having good qualities, because the child will become like the mother. Because when you have a mother like Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, you produce children like Zainab alayhi salam. Both Fatima al-Zahra and Sayyidah Zainab suffered the weight of calamities and masa'ib. Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam said that tribulations showered upon me, which that if they were placed on days, they would have turned into nights. The same Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam was inflicted with so much misfortunes that she was known today as Umm al-Masa'ib, the mother of misfortunes. Yet both women displayed a great display of patience, and inshallah, what we have spoken about in the previous episode was analyzing her sermons, and we see that the level of patience that this woman had. We all know that patience is a great attribute which Islam constantly emphasizes on. The Quran says, "Be patient over what befalls you." And another well-known ayah in the Holy Quran which says, "Verily Allah is with the patient ones." In our life, every single one of us will experience a moment where we have to be patient. Every single one of us, every single one of us will experience this. Are we able to be patient in moments of hardship? Are we able to accept the circumstances we find ourselves in? And it is from Zainab that we learn patience from. Now going back to the sermon of Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam, which she delivered in the court of Yazid, I want to focus on the part where she says, "O son of the freed slaves." When talking about the way he had treated her and the household of the Holy Prophet, why does she say that? An interesting perspective to this is that she was reminding him and those around him that Yazid's ancestors were non-believers. You see, after the opening of Mecca by the Muslim army, all those who refused to submit to Islam, instead preferring the barbaric acts of burying their daughters alive and all the other things they were doing, they were taken hostages. Hence, Yazid's father, Muawiyah, and the grandfather, Abu Sufyan, were also taken as slaves. Okay, so here's the part I want you to focus on. Ironically, it was Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, her grandfather, who bestowed freedom upon them by ordering the release of all slaves. So here's Zainab is revealing to Yazid that when they had power over him and they were slaves, we released you and not abused you, which is contrary to your actions, Yazid. As now that you have the upper hand, You have exercised your power not by being compassionate and understanding, but instead you have killed us, you have abused us, and you have paraded us, and you continue to try to humiliate us. And my dear brothers and sisters, let this be a lesson to everyone. As long as they don't have power, they are good. The minute they get in an ounce of power, they begin to exercise their power of abuse to others. And we even see it in our community today. When we were in power, we were good to you. Unfortunately, the moment someone gets the upper hand, they become the abusers. And this is what Zainab alayhi salam was saying. Zainab's words clarified exactly who her ancestors are and exactly who the ancestors of Yazid are. She clarified all that to everyone who was present. So it's important to recognize that it was through her speech that people realized that Yazid had in fact fought the Prophet's household, who were believing Muslims. All along, Yazid had been using his propaganda to portray Imam Hussein as a non-believer who did not pray. Yet when they saw the captives being brought into Kufa and Sham, and with the words of Sayyidah Zainab and the speech of Imam Sajjad, they realized that they had been duped. And that's why we say the role of Imam Hussein would not be complete if it wasn't for Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam. Imam Hussein's message would have not reached others if it wasn't the words of Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam. Even after she arrived in Medina after Karbala, she was the voice of justice. Her role during the Battle of Karbala and after the Battle of Karbala, and even way after Ashura, played a big role in keeping the movement alive. Historians consider Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam as the key to the victory of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam's rising. It was her who established the mourning ceremonies, this tradition which has lived in the memories and hearts of millions of Muslims to this day, has kept the sacrifices of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam alive and brought dynamism to every movement that aimed at removing injustices on this earth. And that is something we can all learn from. We need to be the voice of justice. We need to ensure oppression does not take place under our watchful eye. Just in recent times in Damascus, we continue to see the Umayyads striving to destroy the existence of Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam by daily attempts to attack the shrine. And this has happened not just long ago, until, you know, our time. This continued resistance against allowing the existence of even the remembrance of this character reaffirms her significance in standing against oppressors, even in her death. They find the shrine threatening because of the legacy of who Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam embodies. When Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam said, "For Wallah lam tanhu dhikrana," she meant her words, and now we and many millions of others are retelling her tragedy and her remembrance, which is echoed worldwide. When Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam, "You will never be able to erase our memory," until today, no one is able to erase her memory. And I leave you with one last point from the speech of Sayyidah Zainab in Sham, which she says, "Allah is sufficient to deal with you. The Messenger of Allah is the Messenger of Allah and Jibreel is our support and help against you." Sometimes in life, if someone wrongs you, just know that Allah is sufficient to deal with them. Justice will also prevail both in this world and the hereafter. And Zainab alayhi salam constantly repeats this to Yazid. "You may have destroyed and defeated us physically, but socially and spiritually, we are the winners. And there will be a day where you will have to answer for your actions. And we must also apply the same to our life. Believe me, if someone wrongs us, Allah is sufficient to deal with them. And know that there is an external force which is looking after us." You see, there are many links and many similarities between Fatima and Zainab, comparison in their speeches, their pain. Both of them were protecting the Imama. And as we mentioned in the episode, both were extremely patient, despite several tragedies befalling them. It's important to also note that it was Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam who was one of the key narrators of this event. But when you see her deliver the sermon in Kufa and Sham, just remember whose daughter she was and who she saw deliver a very powerful sermon also protecting her rights. Yet the patience they both displayed is something to be admired. Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq alayhi salam said, "Verily, sabr is to faith what the head is to the body. The body perishes without the head, and so also when sabr goes, the faith also disappears." And these two women displayed the best form of patience, as explained in the previous four episodes. So we send our salams to Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam, and we just hope that we are able to emulate even a small portion of her attributes. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.